If you want to improve your relationship with social media or want to use social media less, then you want to build your self-esteem. You want to improve your self-confidence. And the more confident you become about yourself, the less you will care about what others are thinking or saying about you. The less you will care about posting online in order to seek validation, recognition, or acknowledgement from others. You won't care as much anymore. So that's why build your self-esteem. And I've already mentioned this in a previous video. Be nice to yourself, improve your self-talk. It's so easy to be our own biggest critic. We say the nastiest things to ourselves, but what about being our own biggest fan? We are waiting for others to make positive statements about ourselves. When others make positive statements, even strangers, then we allow ourselves to make those statements as well. Don't wait for others. Make positive statements about yourself now. Look in the mirror, smile at yourself, high five. If you call your friends bro, call yourself bro. Be friendly, be nice to yourself. The second tip is to look after yourself. So be honest, if you look in the mirror, are you happy with how you look like in terms of your hair? Do you see any nose hair coming out of your nose maybe? Or you're not happy with your facial hair or how you dress, how you smell? Go on YouTube and look for tips on grooming, for example, or how to dress. There's so much information out there on YouTube. So improve yourself, and of course, go to the gym. When you go to the gym, you will feel good about yourself, and you will train yourself to be consistent with your actions, right? Because we want instant gratification. But when we go to the gym, we feel good about ourselves, but only after a while we see evidence that it is working. We see physical change after a while only. But when we see that, it's going to build momentum because it basically tells us that we should keep at it. We should keep going. We should keep going to the gym, and we will train ourselves to understand, okay, so if I take action now, it doesn't mean that there's going to be immediate effect, immediate change, no. But if I keep it up, then there will be long-term effects. And that's what you want. That's how you want to train yourself. Don't go after instant gratification. Learn that if you wait, if you're patient, then the results will come in the future. So go to the gym. You will see difference in terms of how you look, how you feel, and that's going to build momentum. So look after yourself, be nice to yourself, look after yourself, and be very mindful of the people you surround yourself with. So if you want to build your self-esteem and confidence, then be surrounded by people who want to do the same. People who are optimistic, who want to learn, who want to educate themselves, who are nice to themselves as well, who are nice to you and nice to themselves, who look after themselves. So be surrounded by people who are already confident or want to boost their self-confidence and self-esteem. Also, those people should lift you up, should be very supportive about you and your new endeavors, projects, and objectives. So you never want to be surrounded by people who will tell you, why are you going to the gym? Why are you going to the gym? Why don't you eat pizza with us today? Like, why are you watching that video on grooming? Like, who cares? So, you know, you don't want to be surrounded by those people who will criticize you when you try to improve yourself. So be very mindful of the people you surround yourself by. You want to be surrounded by people who will make you feel happy, who you want to speak to, who you want to open up, who you want to be vulnerable with and transparent with. That's what you want. And also, as I mentioned just now, educate yourself, learn new things, find out what it is that you want, what kind of passions do you have. You want to place your energy and focus on something, right? We people want to place our energy and focus and attention on something, but what is it? You know, some have these hobbies that they place their focus and attention on, or they place their focus on work or like a particular project or business that they're working on. Find that thing that makes you tick, that makes you excited, that makes you come alive. Find that thing. What is it that you like? What is it about yourself that you're so good at? You know, learn more about yourself. What are your talents? What are your skills? What kind of set of skills would you like to gain in order to achieve specific results in your life? Where do you want to go? Make those goals, make those plans for yourself, educate yourself, watch videos on communication, relationships, learn something new and be proud of yourself that you are experimenting, that you are curious, that you are interested in the unknown, right? So the more you learn about the unknown, about your goals, about self-development, the more you understand that there's so much to learn, that it's such a waste of time to be on social media and just scrolling and waiting patiently for positive feedback. So look after yourself, be nice to yourself, be surrounded by the right people, and educate yourself, transform yourself, introspect, build your self-esteem, gain self-confidence, and you will notice that you will care less about social media.